Hey, it's Diane Forster, and guess what? It's time to stop stressing out. How would you like to get the stress out of your life and replace it with surrender? Welcome to this week's episode of I Have Today, and this is episode 6 of a 6-part series that we did, a special series called Change Your Language, Change Your Life. And as a master manifester and a practitioner of the law of attraction, among other things that I do, I have mastered the art of language. And I am telling you, when you take the word stress out of your life and you replace it with surrender, so much magic is going to happen in your life. And I'm going to share this with you because the reason why this is so important is because the effects that stress is having on your body, on your mindset, on your health, the diseases that you are experiencing is because of stress. Now, 95% of disease is caused by stress. There's only a small percentage that's not stress related, which means whatever you're going through, if you have chronic pain or headaches or gastritis or any GI issues for that matter, if you're suffering from depression, bipolar, manic depression, any other ailments that you are having going on with you, it is caused from stress. And there is actually no such thing as disease. It's dis-ease of the mind, and it's all created in the mind first. And since stress is causing 95% of it, doesn't it become really important that we get the stress out of our lives? So you might be listening to me right now and going, Diane, how am I going to do that? You know, you don't even know my life. You don't know anything about me. And I've got a lot of pressures in my life and there's a lot of stress in my life. And so that's not even possible. And I'm here to tell you, I know where you've been. I have been stressed out a lot in my life. I attempted suicide. It doesn't get lower than that. Let me tell you that. So I am telling you that anything is possible for you if you open up your mind to the concept of this and allow the tips that I'm going to give you today to integrate into you and be open to implementing them in your life and watch the magic that starts to happen for you. So the whole reason I created this series is because I discovered that a girlfriend of mine who I spent 40 minutes on a train ride with said the word worry 45 times in 40 minutes. And it stuck out like a red flag to me. I started counting it because she said the word worry so much. And the same day that that happened, the same exact day, I heard Zig Ziglar share a story about American Indians that there's no reported cases of any of them that stutter. And the reason why is in their language, they don't have a word for stutter, so it doesn't exist. And ding, 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 the light bulb went off. And that started me developing these processes around removing certain words out of my life that weren't serving me and replacing them with more empowering words. And I teach my clients how to do it. And in this series, these are the top 6 that you need to get out of your language. So if you're new to my channel, I would like to ask you to please subscribe, hit the bell so you can get alerted when we have new videos coming out. And if you haven't caught the other 5 episodes, catch those in addition to all of our other episodes that I have today. Some weeks it's just me in the studio and some weeks I have guests on who talk about their own reinventions in life and how they've come out on the other side. So it's always really powerful. It's inspiring, it's educational, and it's empowering to you. All right. So let me share with you the top 3 things that you need to do. And I did this with 3 A's to make it easy on you. So the first A that I want to share with you is the word allow. So what this means is there is no force. There is no struggle. We create this for ourselves. If you are trying to force an outcome, if you are struggling in a situation, if you're trying to force an outcome of, you know, maybe you're in a relationship and you're struggling to make this relationship work and it feels like effort and it's force, this is not good. And then maybe you're trying to struggle through getting something done and struggling to try and figure something out. That does not work. That's all called assertion and force. And we live in a universe of receptivity and allowance. And so when you're in those situations where you feel like it's a struggle and it's just uncomfortable and it's stressing you out, that is the time that you have to back away from the situation and surrender it. Allow, surrender it up to the universe. What I personally do is when I'm in those situations, and you ever have a day like that where like you just feel like, you know, nothing could go right, like you stub your toe, you get stuck in a traffic jam, you spill coffee on yourself, you have a fight with a loved one, you get a parking ticket, like you feel like that energy is going that way and it's stressing you out, right? What you're doing is you are forcing yourself through that day from a stressful state. And what is happening is you are getting more of it and more of it and more of it. Just keeps getting piled on. What you need to do in that moment is just back away from it, step away from it, and just go, I'm giving this up to the universe. I don't know what's going on, but I am giving up I'm surrendering this right now to you, and I am going to allow you to change the energetic field around me so that I can be in the receptive mode instead of the struggle and the stress mode. So the first A is the word allow. So start allowing yourself to step away from things and allow the universe to just correct, and it will correct. As soon as you change that state from the force to just the relax, the allowance, it's gonna turn on a dime. You're just gonna say, how come my day just got so much better? And in fact, I'm gonna give you that statement right now. I want you to start saying and affirming, why does my day keep getting better and better? That is a great way to start allowing in your life, all right? That is part of my 30-day challenge on how to have a better day, better today, and that's day one. So, why does my day keep getting better and better? Okay, the second A word is ask. Ask. Ask for help. Ask for guidance. Ask for support. Ask the universe to help you, or your angels, or spirit, or God, or the divine, or collective consciousness, or whatever it is that you call it. Have you ever prayed for something in your life? You know, you just kind of prayed and you asked for something, or you asked for something and you aren't really attached to it. It wasn't like a worried prayer. It was just like, you know, this is what, God, I would really like this. Or, you know, dear spirit, please bring this to me. Or wouldn't that be nice if, or you just sort of asked or prayed for something and then you got it, right? You gotta ask, you gotta tap into the collective consciousness, the universe, the energetic field that is so loving, so divine, so giving, waiting for you to ask for what it is you want. Here's what I want to share with you. You do not have to struggle in this and stress out in this journey by yourself. It's when we're pushing against and when we're stressed out, which we're creating by ourselves, that we stay stuck in that state. And so if you stop and you pray and ask for the support, ask for the help, allow it to come. Now, this is really going to help you with your health, with your body, with your physical health, with your emotional health, with your mental health, and with your spiritual health. It's really going to change things around, because as you stop stressing, the more and more you stop stressing every day, you are giving your physical body the chance to realign and do what the cells already know how to do. This mechanism that we live in, this body that we live in, is so fantastically organized, just like the universe is, just like planet Earth is. You know, we don't need to tell the sun to shine. We don't need to tell the earth to spin on its axis, or for the waves to come in and out, or how the birds should fly, or how trees grow, or anything for that matter. It's so perfectly designed, and so are our 50 trillion cells. As soon as you start taking the pressure off and the stress off, it's going to start healing itself. It knows exactly what to do. It's so amazing. Have you heard stories in the past of these like miraculous stage 4 cancer patients all of a sudden getting into complete remission, or people who were suddenly in wheelchairs getting up and walking, and all of these like miraculous healings that happen? You know where it comes from? The mind, the state of mind, having a healthy mindset, and getting rid of stress and living in gratitude instead. So start asking for the support of the universe around you and start paying attention to what starts happening for you. All right, so the third A word is assume. Now, yeah, I know you've heard in the past, oh, don't assume anything that makes an ass out of you and me, and that is not true. You should assume that things are working out for you. Be under the assumption that things are always working out for you. Things are always okay. You are supposed to get what you want, and assume a positive outcome. Do not live in stress and some of the other words that we covered, like fear, worry, doubt, that things are not going to, that the other shoe is gonna drop, or just because something hasn't worked out for you in the past, that it won't work out for you. That is a bad assumption. What I want you to do is I want you to assume that things are working out for you. But here's the thing. It is not our natural state to be in stress. It's not. This is something we human beings have done on our own. You know, when we came into creation and civilization and the evolution of who we were, the reason why we have those stress receptors is because we needed them to be keep us on alert if we were being chased by a saber-toothed tiger, you know, and had to have that ability right there. And so, as Dr. Joe Dispenza says, you know, when that all happened, you know, if when that did happen, it was, you know, 15, 30 minutes later, that stress receptor was gone. You know, it was down and things were back to normal. Well, we're operating and moving in our lives in a constant state of stress. And our pineal glands, our adrenals are so fatigued, and it's causing the disease and the illness that's happening in your body. So you need to assume that you are safe. You need to assume that you are well. You need to assume that you are always going to have everything that you need. Because I'm telling you right now, if you are sitting here watching me or listening to me and listening to these words right now, I want you to think in this moment, because this is really powerful. I have everything I need right now. You truly have everything you need right now. If you're able to listen or hear this right now, I'm sure you've had water today. I'm sure you've had food today. I'm sure you've slept in a bed today. Do you know how many people in this planet never sleep in a bed? Do you know how many people in this planet have to travel miles and miles and miles to get food and water every day? You're pretty damn blessed. So assume that you are okay and that you have everything you need and that you are going to be okay. Assume the positivity and surrender the negative and the stress. Give it up. All right. So this is a way for you to stop being stressed out, to really manage your level of stress and relieve your level of stress, because it is only hurting you. And you can wipe out the word stress from your life. Please don't say, oh, I'm stressed out. I'm so stressed out. You know, I do a lot of work. I do mantra meditations and different modalities for clients, really focused on this work and this language and really reframing this. Think about it. You don't need to ever say that word again. You really don't. And I take a lot of young adults, college age students, you know, postgraduate students, because they're growing up in a world where there's so much pressure with them, right? And they are constantly stressed out, including my own two kids as they were going through college. And I help and guide them to get the stress out of their lives because they don't really know any better. And so being able to do this for you, no matter what age you are, This is a decision that you get to make today. You can choose right here, right now, to never be stressed again. Just say, I refuse to feel this way anymore. I refuse to say that anymore. I refuse to have this be a part of my journey and my experience anymore. I can choose to surrender instead. Surrender and allow, ask, and assume in my life. And choose those three A's and live that way. And surrender and give up the stress in your life. You don't need it. And what I really want to encourage you to do is write to me. Comment on this video. Comment to me at info@DianeForster. And let me know what starts to happen for you as you are alleviating this stress from your life because you started to surrender instead. I really want to hear your stories. I love the case studies. I could possibly put this in my next book. So please make sure. I love having you as part of the I Have Today family, and I want to hear your progress and your success. All right. So I would like to give you a gift. If you are stressed out about money, which I know a lot of people are, we have scarcity mindset thinking, and 80% of the clients I work with, it's the number one issue that they come to me with, is their money mindset. But I want to give you a tool, an amazing free gift that's going to allow you to switch around that scarcity money mindset to an abundance mindset in under 5 minutes a day. How cool is that? And all you got to do is listen to it. So go to my website, opt in, and you will get it right away and start listening to that every single day. Some of my clients listen to it multiple times a day, but at least once a day, and set your mind up for success first thing in the morning. You know, Les Brown has said, the way you spend the first 20 minutes of your day will set you up for success or failure. So how are you spending the first 20 minutes of your day? Are you picking up your phone and checking emails and texting and checking social media? Or are you doing the inner work, which is so important? Are you taking care of you, doing self-care, self-awareness, self-gratitude, self-appreciation? This is a great way to do it. So thank you so much for being here. And we will have links to certain, everything that we've talked about will also be in the description area. So go to my website and get that free money mantra meditation. All my social media links are down there. Feel free to follow me there as well. And make sure you subscribe to this channel, hit the bell. And if you heard something that was really powerful for you today, please pay it forward and pass it along. And don't keep me a secret. So I really appreciate you. Thanks so much for being here, and I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.